room, and there are big developments tonight in the Tom Mihaljevic investigation. He is the Lincoln High School football coach who was suspended last month after allegations of excessive discipline involving a now former football player. Patrick Bell has just spoken with that player's attorney. You have obtained a copy of what the Des Moines public schools are looking into.
Yep, I have, and here it is, a nearly 50-page report in which investigators, quite frankly, blast the conduct of suspended football coach Tom Mihaljevic. These findings reveal he not only violated the district's bullying and harassment policy, but punishment given to a former football player during practice constitutes corporal punishment, according to the district. But that's not all. Investigators believe Mihaljevic engaged in conduct unbecoming of a staff member and insubordination. Now, the reports were released today by the attorney representing former player Dante Campero. The teenager was forced to run and do other strenuous activity due to a negative tweet he made against the varsity squad. The district finds that Campero was indeed subject to intentional physical punishment, bullying, and harassment.
Part of being a high school football coach is tough love. There's no question about that. And when you agree to put on the pads to play for a high school team, you know that's part of the bargain. The conduct that occurred by these coaches far exceeds anything that anybody could reasonably expect. And that, indeed, that was the finding of the district.
And the Campero family originally claimed the teen was forced to run for 2 hours as punishment. That didn't turn out to be the case, investigators say. Video evidence shows that punishment couldn't have lasted for any more than 32 minutes. Now, Des Moines schools have just released a statement saying, in part, and I quote here, "We took the time necessary to be extremely careful and thorough in this review. While it's unfortunate that this report was released by the complainant prior to the completion of our process, the report does confirm that some allegations were founded and that some were not. While the district's investigation is complete, this remains a personnel matter as our process continues and a final decision is not yet determined. To be clear, the school district does not accept any employee or volunteer who does not uphold the best interests of our students, whether in the classroom or in extracurricular activities." Now, we have spoken with Coach Tom Mihaljevic. Mm-hmm. Kevin, he told us he can't comment, really, until he consults with his attorney, but we'll have much more on this developing story coming up at 6.
Is he expected to talk publicly about this, do you think?
We don't know. The first time he heard about this was when we called him.
Okay.
So we'll see.
Thank you very much. Very interesting.